Welcome students. Today I will say a very few lines regarding the sexual recombination, which one called as your Mendelian recombination. And you should know about it for your knowledge sake. What is the sexual recombination or why it is called as Mendelian recombination? Actually, that recombination may be arised under the process of Mendelian hypothesis. Okay? Mendelian generally proposed some hypothesis regarding the what? Inheritance. In there, he mentioned the recombination. A recombination usually arising at there where the linkage is weak. You already know that term recombination from that description. But here you know what is the sexual recombination, why it is beneficial for the process of evolution. During the process of gamete formation, remember, and fertilization, a great array of recombination of pairs of genes occurs because of the what? Segregation, independent assortment, and crossing over. Where is it there? Understand or not? Recombination is important for three main reasons. Okay? One reason is there. It brings about the combination of genes contained in the parents. Okay? Through the chromosomes. You already know. Suppose you may go through the your Mendelian principle about the tall, flat, and it's a diploid body, which will exhibit the teeth, and that is the autosomal, what? Chromosomal expressions, double hybrid. So, you can express likely capital T. It is a pure life form, and suppose it is a male one, then it is crossed with the one dwarf, and that would be one female. Suppose the female plant is the male plant, or you can say it is the male flower, the female flower. Okay, so when it comes to the your female reproductive hole, and you see if they are also giving the gametes. These are the gametes, they will be called at the end of the gametogenesis. These are the parental generation, these are the first group of the gametic production. They will be recombined, having the what hybrid in there, capital T, small t. The protein is which will be arising by they must be hybrids, heterozygous ones. And they will be what? Recombined in there. By recombination, they will be arising. Okay, they will not be permitted in there. That means the chromosomes and genes also remaining in there. Through the chromosomes, genes are coming in there and they are exhibiting the character. They will not be paid immediately. Okay, and there is no exchange of the fragment of the chromatids in between the non-sister chromosomes or non-sister chromatids. Okay, and secondly, this infant group would be act as the parent, second group of parents, and they also be held the gametes under the process of gametogenesis. Okay, likely, and these are called as the second group of the gametes, they would be produced. And after that, suppose they would be transmitting each other. Suppose this is the female and this one is the male in there. Suppose they make a cross, self-pollination. What would happen in there? You see, in the monohybrid class, in Jacob's board, we can draw the four what spaces, and this is the position of the male gamete, in the position of the female gamete. Okay, mark here. Both progenies or offspring would be arise among four, two are also the same as either the parents, other two in between them are the intermediate forms. Okay? And in the accumulation may be arranged. That means that is based upon the your what? Your segregation. That means law of independent. But assignment, no, that is not. Law of segregation is called as law of period of characters. But in case of the dihybrid class, in there you can easily observe the independent assignment, law of independent assignment in there. And crossing over will be arrived at the time of but weak linkage. That means recombination must be there. And at where the recombination is arrived, that means the crossing over must be forming in there. Okay, the recombination is the important for three main reasons. It brings about the combination of genes contained in the parents. Second thing, the number of recombination of genes is infinity, larger than the possible number of genes mutations. And you know the mutations is a one type of what biological phenomena, and it will be arise at the time of adverse condition. And when the process mutation is arrived, immediately the genes are what change their behavior. Such genes are called as mutant genes. The characters which are exhibited by the genes, these are called as what? The mutant characters, and that is caused by the mutants. Okay? And the process or phenomena is known as mutation. Okay, the number of recombination of genes is infinitely larger than the possible number of genes mutations. And lastly, you know, the cumulative result of the recombination may lead to your post-adaptation and your pre-adaptation. Post or pro. Pro-adaptations or post. You should write here post. This is better to remember it. Your post-adaptation. Pro-adaptation or post-adaptation. Okay. Post-adaptation and pre-adaptation. Let us know about them. What is your post-adaptation? What the meaning of the pre-adaptation? Post-adaptation, in case of some existing environment, and pre-adaptation means in the new environment. Okay, this is the cumulative result of the recombination may lead to the post-adaptation and pre-adaptation. Post-adaptation in case of the same existing environment, and pre-adaptation means in the new environment. And in that time or in that period, the recombination may be accomplished. Okay? And this is your sexual recombination or Mendelian recombination. Thank you all.